was a hard-fought game, both teams. Watching those guys on film, I said it before, you can't look at their record because they compete, they battle, they play hard. And it's amazing how they get down in games, how they rip themselves back in. So just trying to make our guys understand this game, won't be able to the buzz of silence because of the way they play, how hard they compete. I've said before, Sword is probably the best in the country at attacking the rim, the transition. Put so much pressure. I thought Fred came out and gave those guys big minutes. They did a good job as a team. It's always tough with Rockwell, how hard he plays, he battles, he physically plays. But I just told our guys it was more mental for us in a game like this, even though it was a physical game. You know, that mental hump, you go ahead and try to move forward. You know, worrying about, you know, bubbles, NC and all that. Just play a basketball game, try to win the game, come on.
Coach, didn't feel too much different from the A&M game when they came out and shot hot in the second half. I guess what was the difference this time in being able to kind of shut off their runs and come out on top?
I just think, you know, making enough plays offensively. I think in the A&M game, probably didn't make enough plays, but just making enough plays. I don't think we played well defensively. Give those guys credit for really attacking the rim. And they have the right kind of guys with the new rule. You just put your head down and get to the rim and try to get fouled. And again, Swartz one of the best. And we knew that. Our scout report said that, how he gets to the rim. But I didn't think we did a very good job. Of course, they would come out fighting, playing with energy. But we got enough stops, and I thought Jordan played well offensively for us to get us rolling. Jerron has some big offensive rebounds to keep us going.
You mentioned your message to the team, just kind of told them to ignore everything else. I mean, with all the bubble talk and everything like that, you like to see this kind of response out of them in a game where so much has been said the past week.
Well, I think for our guys, I mean, it's good to get this win. But it seems as if they were playing with, you know, 15, 20-pound weight on their back, you know, just – you get it off your back and go ahead and play the basketball game. Like I told you guys, whatever happens, happens. But we got to play and we got to compete. We probably played well for 30, 35 minutes.
You talked about Jordan playing well offensively. He had those back-to-back dunks kind of in the middle of the second half and it really seemed to kind of, you got in a lull and it jolted you awake. I mean, did you think that was kind of a turning point?
I thought so. And again, you know, the game goes back and forth. But again, we got enough stops. We knew these guys would keep coming the way we would drill, penetrate, attacking the rim. And making plays, but I thought so. I thought he, you know, made a couple of threes. I thought he passed up on a couple of three-point shots, but him ripping and going and tackling the rim, it was big for us.
There was a play there where it looked like Jarnell was a little frustrated underneath the basket. Was that just more frustration at some of the defense, or I mean, was it kind of getting to the point where it kind of felt like some similar games where teams had made second-half comebacks?
I like the energy he had. You think you said down there by their bench?
Yeah.
I like that energy he had. I mean, which was great, because he was saying about a guy that broke down on the defensive assignment. So I like that part about it, because he's, as you know, he's not one of the guys that shows a lot of emotion from that standpoint. But what happened, it builds up, and you know, as players, time is winding down. And, you know, I'm glad it came out. And, good thing we didn't get a tight ball slammer. But that was good to see from him, because he's not a very vocal guy, but him to step up and say something meant a lot.
Had strong finishes in the past. I mean, is there something in this team that, when their back's really against the wall, maybe it brings out a little something extra in them? Or are you hoping that's the case right now?
Well, not necessarily hoping. You prepare yourself and do your job. But for me, that's been my lifestyle. You fight to the end. Whatever happens, happens. That's the thing I try to portray to our players. You never give up regardless of situation, circumstances. You keep battling, let the chips fall away, man.
There's a point where it was 20-6 in the paint, and just seem like your kids kind of can take a scouting report to the court and know where their advantage is immediately and go attack it.
Well, I think what happened here, we want to try to bring the ball inside with both our bigs and also use a dribble penetration. But I thought they did a good job of getting us stagnant and spurts in the first half. It was sagging so tough. They doubled the post and they had guys in the lane. So it was either shooting three-point shots, and we didn't want that thing to be 33-point shots in the game. So to kind of put your head down and try to get in the lane, shoot some pull-ups, try to get to the rim. We didn't want to settle for a lot of three-point shots.
I know you juggled the starting lineup a little bit, Barton, in there. I mean, did you think – I know he didn't score a ton, but what did you think just from that look?
I thought he played well. And even for my gauge, I normally look at the score line. I see Jordan score. I normally look at – until I get home at night, really look at the stat sheet. I don't look at the defensive numbers, rebounding numbers, free throw. I thought he played well just with my eyes. Whether he scored or not, I thought it was probably his best game in my opinion. Being vocal on the defensive side of the ball, really running the team. If he doesn't score, as long as he's running the team, that's what I say about it. If they run the team, defending at a high level, I'm fine with it.
With move to put Barton back? Is that just because Darius has kind of had struggled to maybe contain some of these points?
I think not necessarily how he struggled. I don't think he didn't want to play great, but I just think with Tone's experience, Tone's threat is a threat to score the ball. And Darius really been working the shot. He made a 3-point. He's really aggressive attacking off the dribble, which was good. But I just think the experience got down the stretch allow Darius to relax a little bit, to come off the bench, to be more at ease. And I thought it helped tonight.
Playing moving forward to keep Tone there?
Yeah, and I've never been a guy to keep changing every other game. I mean, it is what it is unless somebody gets injured.
Coach, can you talk about what it means for the team to get a boost off the bench like Armani gave you tonight?
I thought Armani did a great job, really playing hard. I mean, he's an energy guy. He's spent hours and hours working on his 3-point shot. He's improved. I'm not sure if he made one tonight, but a guy that battles, he's one of those guys that can play a 2, 3, or 4 position for us, and he really helps us defensively. You want a smaller, quicker guy and a bigger guy. So I thought he did a good job on Rock Quiz when he was guarding him. Probably not as well in the post, but he knows how to move his feet. He's physical enough. But to have a guy like that come off your bench and give that kind of energy is good.